Joaquin Phoenix delivered an emotional speech after his Oscars award the other night for his performance as the Joker. And boy, is Joaquin one hell of a Joker, or just a terrible dishonest actor, like the rest of them.
And I do not feel elevated above any of my fellow nominees or anyone in this room, because we share the same love, the love of film, and this form of expression has given me the most extraordinary life. I don't know what I'd be without it. But I think the greatest gift that it's given me, and many of us in this room, is the opportunity to use our voice for the voiceless. I've been thinking a lot about some of the distressing issues that we are facing collectively. And I think at times we feel, or we're made to feel, that we champion different causes. But for me, I see commonality. I think whether we're talking about gender inequality, or racism, or queer rights, or indigenous rights, or animal rights, we're talking about the fight against injustice. We're talking about the fight against the belief that one nation, one people, one race, one gender, or one species has the right to dominate, control, and use and exploit another with impunity. I think that we've become very disconnected from the natural world, and many of us, what we're guilty of is an egocentric worldview, the belief that we're the center of the universe. We go into the natural world and we plunder it for its resources. We feel entitled to artificially inseminate a cow, and when she gives birth, we steal her baby, even though her cries of anguish are unmistakable. And then we take her milk that's intended for her calf, and we put it in our coffee and our cereal. And I think we fear the idea of personal change, because we think that we have to sacrifice something to give something up. But human beings at our best are so inventive and creative and ingenious. And I think that when we use love and compassion as our guiding principles, we can create, develop, and implement systems of change that are beneficial to all sentient beings and to the environment. Now, I've been a scoundrel in my life. I've been selfish, I've been cruel at times, hard to work with, and ungrateful, but so many of you in this room have given me a second chance. And I think that's when we're at our best, when we support each other, not when we cancel each other out for past mistakes, but when we help each other to grow, when we educate each other, when we guide each other towards redemption. That is the best of humanity. When he was 17, my brother wrote this lyric. He said, "Run to the rescue with love, and peace will follow."
And I think the New York Post summed this up nicely. Two things bother me about this. One is how people are so stupid that they can't see through this obvious propaganda. They fall right into the charade, similar to how people fall into the carnivore diet charade. How can anyone buy this complete dog crap nonsense? Two is that the people who are vegan deny the painfully obvious vegan agenda. Anyone with a semblance of intelligence knows that nothing positive ever makes it to mainstream news, and the propaganda pushing this vegan diet has a sinister outcome of infertility and slavery. Plus, vegan girls are ugly. They're not pretty, so. But, the vegan soy boys are kind of cute, so. So the main argument being pushed here is speciesism. If you wouldn't hurt a dog or a cat, you shouldn't hurt other animals. But we know vegans don't actually care about health, as they always end up admitting the diet is about causing the least amount of harm to animals. These vegans will argue up and down about the health aspects of the diet, the environment, the morals, and when they are proven wrong on every single front, only then will they admit the truth. The truth being that vegans are simply cute, cuddly animal lovers. Oink, oink. Now, whether you want to dress up in a fursuit and play with your boyfriend, or just play footsies with a cute animal, at least admit it and stop making up lies that are harming people's health. Following a vegan diet harms human health. So how can you say, oh, if you wouldn't hurt a dog or a cat when you're harming humans? Just like following a carnivore diet harms human health. I would say, though, vegans have much better arguments than carnivores for convincing people. All they say is, "Arr, I feel pretty good on this grade-A grain-fed corn-stuffed Angus prime beef, and so do my friends." Let's take a look at an interview from Plant-Based News a week ago.
So my name's Klaus, really great to meet you. You're obviously here at an activist event. I know you've been vegan for how many years?
42 years.
First of all, Joaquin looks horrible. We did a video around November, I think like 3 months ago, talking about how bad he looked in the Joker movie. He's only in his 40s. The vegan diet clearly isn't doing him any good if he is adhering to it. And isn't it a bit odd that it takes so long for him to think about the answer to that question? Also, the body movement shying away from the interview, you know, looking away when he's answering it. You would think Joaquin was asked that question many times and has a clear answer for it. Or his brain is just going through what he has been told to say, and he's making sure it's correct.
Wow, that's amazing. I've noticed that you've sort of been more active in recent years. Is there any reason why you've kind of chosen more recent times to speak out a little bit more?
I think maybe that's true in some ways. I think also might have to do with a certain level of visibility that I might have now, so maybe people are more aware of ways that I'm participating. But I think it is true in some ways that I'm trying to be more active now. I don't know what the reason is, honestly.
You know what the reason is. Vegan agenda is in full swing, baby. Stock those shelves up with the soy slop, the Beyond Meat. What's the other stuff? The Impossible Burger.
Was it in the back of your head maybe a motivation early on in your career that you could make it to the top and kind of hold back that message until you're at the top, or was it kind of just an organic thing?
No, I think that when it's your time to step up, then it comes to you. I think I've always had a hard time imposing my own personal beliefs on others or my values, right? And I've never wanted to do that. I've wanted to encourage people to understand where I'm coming from. But I think that things are really dire right now. And the evidence is overwhelming, both that there is an incontrovertible link between the meat and dairy industry and climate change. And I think it's something that people are waking up to. They realize that they cannot be protectors of the environment and not be vegan. And so I don't know why, man. It feels right. There's an opportunity, and I have the opportunity to amplify the voice of the activists that are out here every day or weekly doing their work. And so I'm in a very unique position to be able to talk about their great work and to amplify their message. And so I think we find the way that we can play our parts.
Meat and dairy are linked to climate change. So are vegan farts. I can't stand debunking this over and over. Animal agriculture in general is 3% of CO2 emissions, let alone meat and dairy specifically. CO2 emissions themselves account for less than 1% of greenhouse gases, and climate is regulated by solar cycles and various magnetic fields from space, not cow farts or vegan farts for that matter. I would bet a large sum of money that he eats meat or fish on a weekly basis, partially due to his disinterest in his tone of voice, and partially because he can string together more than two sentences without malfunctioning like a regular vegan. Also, why is it always about beef and dairy? Because the truth would stray you far away from going vegan. Corporations control the food supply, whether you eat estrogenic feedlot beef or processed plant-based slop. Dare you point out how much these corporations have damaged the world purely for profit? If you think an individual person has damaged the climate in any capacity compared to what these elites have done, that is a joke. And if you point this out, you will be attacked by their cronies who are collecting mediocre paychecks to live their sad, mediocre lives. Most of these minions have sold their soul against the human race, and they will do it with smiles on their faces. If someone tells you to go vegan or eat feedlot beef, don't support them in any way whatsoever. There may be a few that can be helped, and that's why I work so hard to make videos every single day. It's unfortunate that these paid influencers, these special interest funded people, are able to gather the public so quickly into their movement, and in order to suck those people back out, it's incredibly difficult to do. But what's the end goal? Simple. less rights for you. America has been taking away our rights, going against the Constitution for the past dozens of years, and no one is doing anything about it. Giving into these vegan and carnivore shills is allowing them to continue to control you without realizing what is happening. The food supply remains in their hands, and in order to step away from that, you have to support local businesses, local farms, and put your efforts towards securing a food supply for yourself long term. Thank you guys for joining me. If you could please like the video, subscribe, hit that bell icon, and of course, above all, guys, please share the video. If you guys want to support me further, definitely check out my book, The Ancestral Indigenous Diet, down in the description below. You can also go to Frankie's Free Range Meat for high quality, nutrient dense animal foods. We have Frankie's Naturals for minimal ingredients, minimally processed hygiene and cosmetic products. And you can go to frank-stefano.com for one-on-one health consultations. Thanks again for joining me, guys, and enjoy the rest of your day.